right, shalom, shalom. Brothers of Great Millstone, Church in Birmingham, Alabama. And before we get started, we'd like to give all praises, honor, and glory
to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahusha, Bashem, Kapagash.
Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, the men who taught us this truth. And peace and blessings be to the hope of the late. You men, women, and children that believe on the words of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahusha. So we out here again through the Spirit and mercies of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahusha, to give warning to you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and to tell all of you outside this council that if you don't repent, you're going to be destroyed, man. You know, because we're saying prophecy is manifesting itself. And for you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, it's time for you to repent, man. You know?
It's Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 17. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
Like, and what does a watchman do? A watchman foresees the evil, man, and warns the people. What you got?
Therefore, hear the word in my mouth,
yep,
and give warning from me.
And who is the mouth of Yahweh Shmael Shah? His prophets, man. See, this is nothing new, man. This is of old, man. The Lord said, what? Matter of fact, give me a Ecclesiastes. Real quick, read that again.
Ezekiel 3 and 17. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, hear the word in my mouth,
yep,
and give them warning from me.
So this is the legacy of the prophets, to warn you, man. You know? This is the spirit that the prophets always came in, man. That's why we say, hey, we boldly proclaim that we the prophets of Yahweh by Shemal Shah, because what? You know a tree by its fruits, man. You see? Read again one more time.
Ezekiel 3 and 17, son of man, I have made thee a watchman,
yep,
unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth,
mm-hmm,
and give them warning for me.
Yep, and this is ultimately coming from Yahweh Shemal Shah. You know, that's why you seeing shit happen, man, because where the word of a king is, there's power. We hold power up here, starting with our head elders and apostles of Great Millstone, man. We got the 100% truth over here. We had a mind of our Lord Yahweh Shah, and we warning you what he proclaimed that he's gonna do to this place, which is destroy this place, man. You see him sending out the plagues. You know, you see the famine is beginning to lay hold upon you people, man. The dollar is about to collapse at any given moment, man. Let me get that.
This is the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 1 and verse 9.
Yep.
The thing that hath been, it is that which shall be,
yep,
and that which is done is that which shall be done, mm-hmm, and there is no new thing under the sun.
So there's nothing new under the sun, man. This ain't nothing brand new here. You see the ministry of Yahweh Shah, this is of old, man. You know? You gotta read it again.
This is the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 1 and verse 9. And it says, the thing that hath been, it is that which shall be, and that which is done is that which shall be done, and there is no new thing under the sun.
Hey, and reincarnation is biblical, man. You see? See, you got to be out there, man. You got to be half crazy, man. Really, you got to be crazy to be able to entertain the teachings of our Lord Yahweh Shah, man. Because this is not of this realm here, man. This is from on high. Yes, reincarnation is biblical. That's how we know the prophets is back on the scene, man. You are witnessing the prophets of Yahweh Shemal Shah. Let me get that.
This 1 Corinthians 14 and 32. And the spirits of the prophets,
yep,
are subject to the prophets.
Hey, the spirit of the prophets are subject to the prophets. See, we've been brought here to discern between these things. Give me Malachi 3 and 18, Bible shot. Read again.
1 Corinthians 14 and 32. And the spirit of the prophets,
yep,
are subject to the prophets.
Uh-huh.
I got something for you real quick. Yeah. It's Jeremiah 1 and 5.
Uh-huh.
Before I formed thee, I knew thee in the belly. So like before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee to be a prophet unto the nations. And just bagging up what the brother said, man, the spirit of the prophets are subject unto the prophets, man. It's not like in your past life you was a music musician, and this time you're just going to prophesy. No, man. For lack of better words, you was a prophet in the intro, you're going to come back with that same job. Come back with your profession, man.
Yeah, come on. Jeremiah 28 and 8, the prophets that have been before me and before thee of old,
if I may, that's a legacy. Mm-hmm. You know?
You got it.
Prophesied both against many countries,
mm-hmm,
and against great kingdoms of war
and of evil and of pestilence. And that's what a prophet do, man. A prophet is going to prophesy evils against a certain kingdom. Like a screwdriver is going to screw, and like a hammer is going to hammer, man. The Lord is going to send the prophets to send forth a certain message. And for the lack of better words, 9 times out of 10, that message is going to be unpleasing. That's why it says of war and of evil and of pestilence. You got it.
Book of Daniel chapter 12 verse 13, but go thou thy way till the end be, for thou shalt rest.
That's it. Hey, you gonna die for a lack of better words, you know?
Yeah. And stand in thy lot at the end of the day.
Yeah, you're gonna stand in your lot at the end of the day, because ultimately the job wasn't undone for the lack of better words, man. Because when you go back into Revelation the 10th chapter, it says the same thing all over again, man. Prophesy again. So which means, well, what? You're going to come back and doing the same thing that you had done before, man. You know, Yahweh Shem Yahushua, he's not new, man. Like the prophets being on the scene, that's nothing new. It's just people been stuck in this Western mindset that they have been detached from the ancient world. They have been detached how the Lord works, man. You know? And for a lack of better words, man, when the prophets come out, again, they're going to prophesy bad things, man. They're going to prophesy evil and pestilence. That's why when Samuel entered into a city, they said, what? Comest thou peaceful? Because they knew once a prophet entered the town, 9 times out of 10, it was concerned that somebody finna die. Somebody been going off, man. You know, you got a Malachi.
This Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 15. Give testimony unto those that thou hast possessed from the beginning, and raise up prophets that have been in thy name. That's what the Lord is doing, man. He's raising up prophets in his name, man. He's giving that testimony, the testimony of Yahshua, which is the spirit of prophecy. It's the same testimony he's doing, right?
Yeah. Back in Jeremiah 28, and at verse 9, the prophet was prophesied of peace. When the word of the prophet shall come to pass, then shall the prophet be known that the Lord had truly sent him.
That's it, man, because once you prophesy a certain message, it's going to have to be revealed if it's going to come true, man. And 9 times out of 10, it's basically saying, if you prophesying a peace, hold your tongue, man. But you got it, that's my
brother. This is the book of Malachi, chapter 3, and verse 18.
Yep.
It says, then shall ye return and discern between the righteous and the wicked, between him that serveth Yehovah and him that serveth him not.
So this is how you know who the prophets will be in the last days. See, these things are plain, you know? You are witnessing the ministry of Yahweh.
It says, Malachi verse 3 and verse 18.
And this also proves reincarnation.
It says, then shall ye return.
Return. Come on.
And discern between the righteous and the wicked, between him that serveth Yahweh and him that serveth him not.
Hey, and Yahweh has to bless you with the spirit of discernment, man. You know? Because keep in mind, brothers that are inside this council have been exposed to these other camps out here, man. You know? But we had the spirit of discernment through the spirit of power, Yahweh Shema Shah. And when we were brought to our apostles and elders' great millstone, hey, right there was where that discernment was acted out, man. That's when it was put into play. You see? But it ain't of us, it's of Yahweh Shema Shah. You know? Because we see what happens to the people that follow after these other camps. We understand your destiny, man. You're going to be destroyed, man. Ain't no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Ain't no middle parts, you see? You have to believe upon what we tell you, man, through the spirit of power, Yahweh Shema Shah, storming our apostles and elders, the great minister, because we obtain what? The report, man. You know?
Proverbs 22 and verse 3, a prudent man foreseeth the evil, yep, and hide of himself.
Hey, going back to that watchman.
But the simple pass on and are punished.
He said, a prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, man. We hide ourselves in the pavilion of Yahweh Shema Shah. Because we understand that's our only way of living. You know? Everything outside of Yahweh Shema Shah is dead, man. You know, it's vain. You know, it's vanity. You know, even Solomon told you that.
Proverbs 22 and verse 3, a prudent man foreseeth the evil.
So a wise man foreseeth the evil. We are foreseeing the evil, man. You know? We foresee the pestilence squeezing on you people. We foresee Esau, Edom coming down, having great wrath upon the the children of Israel, man. You see? Read again.
Proverbs 22:3, a prudent man foreseeth the evil and hide of himself, but the simple pass on and are punished.
Hey, so that's the fate of the simple, man. That's the fate of two-thirds. They're gonna pass on and be punished, man. You see, these plagues, when they what, intensify, give me Ezekiel 7, when they intensify, read again, you're gonna pass on and be punished.
Yep. Proverbs 22:3, a prudent man foreseeth the evil and hide of himself, but the simple pass on and are punished.
The simple pass on and are punished.
You got it. You got it. You got it. Be simple. Proverbs 1:32. For the turning away of the simple shall slay them, and the prosperity of fools shall destroy them.
The prosperity of fools shall destroy him. Hey, the Lord is only dealing with the wise, man. You see? He's not dealing with the foolish, man. Because you being foolish and simple in these times, that's going to cost you your fucking life, man.
Right.
You see? See, your life is at stake here. With your how about Shemal shot, man? Read that.
You want to start to talk about
it? Oh, Shalai, he got quick.
All right, this Proverbs 28:9. He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law, even his prayer shall be abomination.
Yep, that's the man and the brother. You know, you being simple, you don't hearken to this word, and you're going to be punished. Because when all hell breaks loose, you're going to be crying out to Jesus, Buddha, Allah. Hey, the Lord ain't going to hear none of that. You gotta cry to your Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah. That's the only way you're gonna be delivered out of the trouble.
If I may, this ain't this what that prayer is concerned. Being delivered, being saved, and the Lord restoring mercy upon you, man. But the bridge to that is this word.
Wow, this is the book of Ezekiel. Book of Ezekiel, chapter 7, and verse 4. It says, "In my eye shall not spare thee, neither will I have pity. But I will recompense thy ways upon thee, and thy abominations shall be in the midst of thee, and ye shall know that I am the Lord."
Uh-huh. And the Lord is not going to have no pity upon you, man. Give me Ezekiel 9 chapter.
It says, Ezekiel 7:4, "And my eye shall not spare thee."
Hey, his eye is not going to spare him, man. You got it, and we got that. You already know that, Isaiah.
Okay. It says, "Neither will I have pity, but I will recompense thy ways upon thee, and thy abominations shall be in the midst of thee, and ye shall know that I am the Lord."
Hey, all of you are going to know the Lord how we know him, man. Exactly. Alashadu, what? Demon-like power, man. You know? See, hey, the Lord is speaking comfortably to Jerusalem, man. You know? He's comforting us, man. Because see what? He gave us what? He made us foresee the evil, man. He put us on game before he was getting ready to spring into action. So we're not going to be taken off guard when these things actually intensify them, man. Because we understand what's going on. We get what's going on, man. This is the works of Yahweh Shemal Shah, the marvelous works of Yahweh Shemal Shah.
It says, verse 4, "Thus said the Lord, Yahweh, and only evil, behold, is come."
Man, going back to the legacy of the prophets, evil and only evil, behold, is come, man. That's what we warning you of. It's not going to get better for America. The Lord has already decreed from the foundations of the earth that America was out of here, man. He said he declared the end from the beginning, man. And his counsel is going to stand. Read again.
It says, "Thus said the Lord, Yahweh, and evil, and only evil, behold, is come. The end is come. Yep. It watches for thee."
Hey, the end is watching on you. It's waiting on you to get there, man. That's how we know it's already been decreed from the beginning. Because it's waiting on your ass to get there. Read again.
It says, The end is come. Yep. It watches for thee. Behold, it is come.
Behold, meaning the look. We see it. By the way, articles. We see it, man. That's how we, hey, what? We measuring time diligently in itself, man.
Read that. Yep, the second edge is 14 and verse 16. "For yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen happen shall be done hereafter."
Hey, it said greater evils, man. Meaning these things, it ain't just gonna stay the same. Yeah, you can still go to the store as you please, but eventually, hey, the Lord spoke of a famine. You see? The Lord spoke of a famine, man. You see what inflation setting in? And eventually what hyperinflation is gonna set in?
You see?
Just wait till the dollar is completely out of here, man. You know? Things things are going according to plan. Read that again.
2 Ezra 14:16. For yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen happen shall be done hereafter.
And like the brother said, hey, greater evils than like over that earthquake over there in Syria, killed 50,000 people. You had the big sea over here killed, they say millions. And they talk about that Marburg feed now. Hey, they gonna kill a lot of people as well. He said, like I said, greater evil. But continuing on, he said, for look how much the world shall be weaker through age, so much the more shall evils increase upon them that dwell therein.
He said evils are gonna increase. Read that again.
Yep.
Evils are gonna increase, so it's not gonna stay the same, man. You know? You have to watch it.
Weaker through age, man. Because again, even the earth is getting weaker, men are getting weaker, even righteousness is getting decreased in this modern day society, man. So the evils ultimately are going to increase in the latter years to bring this place down. You know, you got to do what?
Rebekah 2:3, for the vision is yet for the appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie, though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, it will not tarry. And we seeing it, man. By the way, the prophecy's popping off, man. Huge example is what? The dollar crashing, man. You see? Yeah, you got the famine, inflation. You know, shit is happening, man. The vision is right before your eyes, man. But a lot of you niggas are blind. You can't see it, man.
In fact, add to that, inflation. We can see that Fed now. We can actually see the transition of that digital dollar, man. That new era of how to do different payments, for the lack of better words, man. It's a transition to that new world order, and it's happening before people face. But these niggas are so blind, and you just so wrapped up in LeBron James' basketball career, you can't see that we're at the end of the fucking world, man. You know?
You need to worry about LeBron's stats and shit. Hey, well, LeBron gonna suffer the famine too.
Yeah, he gonna be like you.
You know?
This nigga gotta mention his shit. Yeah. This nigga gonna go hungry too, man. He got cars, or Rolls Royce, or whatever. He probably got a bunker. But he gonna end up just like you. He gonna realize that he's nothing but an ordinary nigga, man.
Yeah.
He gonna get caught up by the famine, man. You know, you gotta.
And then dumb ass nigga probably bought a buck in America. You know, you really think you nigga bought? He don't know no damn. He don't know prophecy, man. He probably bought a buck in America.
Got you, got it. Jeremiah 30:5. For thus saith the Lord Yahweh by Hashem Yahushua, we have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace.
Yep, their voice is trembling. Hey, these prophecies, the things to come. Like the brother just going to, the dollar collapses. Hey, their mark of the beast gonna get set up real soon, man.
That's it. You seeing that transition take place now, man.
Yep.
Everything is about to go different, man.
Yep.
Not too long ago, me and one of the brothers, we went to the little spot to go eat. And she was like, eventually, they're not going to be taking cash no more, man.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm trying to get y'all ready for it.
Yeah. And that's what, that's the plans of the elites, man. So we put on game even to what the left-hand side have in store for you people, man. You are currently in the New World Order, if you didn't know.
Yeah. Hey, they tell you about these things, you won't even believe. You had to do, Aaron Russo.
Yep.
You had an interview with, Alex Jones. You telling the plan that Nick Rockefeller told him about how they want to stick that grain of rice in you, man. Mm-hmm. Hey, your life gonna be on the line pretty soon. Either you gonna take it or you're gonna get put to death, man.
If I make select to going back, hey, Brother Red and Habakkuk going into that vision speaking at the end.
Yeah.
That's what you're seeing. The evidence is mounting up concerning that prophecy. The MOTB. Momentum is not heading towards Christianity. Anything, these devils trying to ban the Bible, these certain fronts that they made in the scriptures. They don't want no dealings with it, but this is what the momentum is heading towards, this digital society. They're getting rid of these digital apps. It's going to be one app now, and Fed now.
Yeah, no.
So you blow up the Fed, it's really
the elite,
right?
Yeah. And so, like, if I may say, hey, this is the doctrine that makes sense, man. It's the only doctrine that makes sense, man, because this lines up with biblical prophecy, man. That's how we know we got the 100% truth over here. All you other camps, you ain't got shit. and you don't have a lot of blood on your hands unless you repent and teach the correct doctrine, man. And all you niggas that's following these other camps, if you don't return back, hey, if you don't come over here to Great Millstone, you gonna die, man.
You said with other doctrines, because this one you can't get wrong. This one doctrine, if you go off on it, is no way of repentance. Yeah. It's for the lack of better words. Once you get right here, you damned in, man. Yeah. So you must hearken to the doctrine of Great Millstone, because if you don't, if you take this, you're gonna be damned. Ooh. You know? Yeah.
Yeah.
Guys don't understand maturation. They don't understand that. They don't understand that the spirit of life that flows from the word is directly coincide with reality. The coming of the world of men. Now what that says, if they stay with paper dollar or, you know, paper food stamps, did they stay with the big bucket phone, right? It all evolved. There's a certain level of gradualism that comes with life. So you mean to tell me when we push the idea of technology moving towards buying and selling digitally, that's not in harmony with prophecy?
See?
See, that's why Yahweh Shah spoke about straining at a net. Because the wisdom, yeah, this counsel right here, and you can't fake it. The entry point is the reasoning of it. Like a child only knows so much. So like, it's like a ceiling with a child. Really don't understand, you don't have the mental capacity to embrace certain things. Yeah, that's why, yes, the testimony of Yahweh Shah is an actual spirit. That's in the book of Revelation 19, 10 verses. Yeah, you got it, man. All right,
just back, brothers up. Proverbs 4:1. Hear ye children the instructions of a father, and attend to no understanding. For I give you good doctrine, forsake ye not my law. You know, just the bad brother, man. Hey, hear ye children, man. Here it is. This is where it's good at. That good news, man. All right? Because the spirit of Yahweh Shah is up here, man. Which what? The testimony of prophecy? You know, that's the spirit of Yahweh Shah. The men of Great Millstone are the only men that's coming with that spirit, man. As well as the light-minded camps, you know, that teach the same doctrine, man. All right? But, you know, up here, this is the good news, man. And it'll be wise unto you to hearken unto this doctrine, man.
Right, can I say, like, Noah's doctrine, it coincided with reality. It became reality. It was a build-up, right? It was a moment where the naysayers started feeling the drops of rain, man. That's true doctrine. Because God's really doctrine outside of ours is to rebuttal us. When you really think about it. So true doctrine, the doctrine of the Yahweh Shah, narrates life and existence. Then you want to have other resistant spirits will say, nope, it's not that. It's actually this. No, that's like a detour sign. The momentum of prophecy and the teachings of Yahweh Shah is veracity. It speaks concern and reality. So now with that said, you got guys who say, for example, MOTB is something outside of what we said is. Well, how that direct, how that correlates with reality? Or whatever form of teaching one might bring.
Hey,
if it don't line up with reality.
So did not, the spirit did not give the sign.
But some men's reality has been blurred because they're not viewing it through the spiritual lens.
The world,
the prophetic,
the gift
aspect of the scripture.
Because we are proper, right?
Yeah, man. Satan trying to stop the block.
We take out some.
It's the book of Titus 1:15. Unto the pure, all things are pure.
Right, unto the pure, all things are pure, man. These times, who will be the pure, man? Somebody get Revelation 14 chapter. Real quick.
Titus 1:15. Unto the pure, all things are pure. But unto them that are defiled and unbelieving, is nothing pure, but even their mind and their conscience is defiled.
Yeah, what you got?
It's Revelation 14:5. And in their mouth was found no guile.
See, but, read again.
Titus 1:15, unto the pure,
all things are pure.
So unto the pure, all things are pure. Go ahead.
But unto them that are defiled and unbelieving.
Yep. Defiled and unbelieving, man. Proverbs 4 and 2. All right? So those that heard this word, it profited them. All right? Because they was mixed with faith, man. And those without faith, go ahead.
It's nothing pure. But even their mind.
But nothing pure, but even their mind, those that does not have faith, go ahead.
In their conscience.
In their conscience, which is what? Their mind, man, where the spirit lies, man. That's where everything that they speak out of their mouth come from. Right? Go ahead.
It's defiled.
It's defiled. And that's why Revelation 14 tells you.
It's Revelation. It's Revelation 14 and verse 5. And in their mouth was found no guile.
Uh-huh.
For they are without fault before the throne of the Most High.
So those are the pure right there. Those are the ones that have been separated. What is that? From the foundation of the world, for the second Ezra. You know what I'm talking about? Right, right. It's one in, yep.
They're going back to the Ephesians 1, and I'm going to start at verse 4. It says, matter of fact, I'm going to start at verse 3. Ephesians 1 and 3, it says, blessed be the power and Father of our Lord, Yahushua Mashiach, who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in the Mashiach. And it's receiving his word, man. Because this word actually comes from above. Let's continue on. According.
And if you say our power,
that's it.
Everybody's power. You got Alahaya
now.
Yeah, that's it.
Alahaya now.
Our power.
Our power. It says, according as he has chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love.
If I may.
Just going back to Revelation 14, it says, without guile, without deceit, without blame, being pure, man, for the lack of better words. And that's what this doctrine is, because you can go into somebody that's a part of IUIC, go into somebody who's a part of another camp, you can ask them certain questions. They will be in the roadblock for the lack of better words. We know we don't know everything, but it's a brother here that's an expert on it for the lack of better words. You go into ICBK, you ask them about Deuteronomy 22nd chapter, they're going to bug out. You know? But let's continue on. And it's the spirit why we can understand this truth. It says, verse 5, it says, having predestinated us until the adoption of, having predestinated us until the adoption of children by Yahushua Mashiach to himself according to the good pleasure of his will, man. So basically, for the lack of better words, Yahushua have given up this truth, given this understanding, and basically adopted us, man. So we can get back in the good graces of Yahushua. How do you get on the Lord's good side? By praise, dancing, and doing a two-step down the aisle? No, man. You get on his good side through the word, through the truth, man. You know? Yeah, believe on him who we have sent, man. You know?
Yeah, I got
it. Yep. This second Ezra 2 and verse 41, the number of thy children whom thou longest for is fulfilled. Beseech the power of the Lord that thy people, which have been called from the beginning, may be hallowed.
He said from the beginning, man. Proving that this is the elect right here, man. Read that again.
It says 2 Ezra 2 and 41, the number of thy children whom thou longest for is fulfilled. Beseech the power of the Lord that thy people, which have been called from the beginning, may be hallowed.
Hey, and this is also our hope there, man. We hoping to be of the elect, man. Those that were hallowed from the beginning, man. You see? This
is what you got. It's the book of Matthew, chapter 13, starting at verse 10. It says, and the disciples came and said unto him, why speakest thou unto them in parables? He answered and said unto them, because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven.
He said it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. Well, what?
But to them it is not given.
Hey.
11, verse 7. What then? Israel have not attained that which he seeketh for.
Yep, and what do the nation of Israel what ultimately seek for? Some form of comfort, man. Answers. You know, because look, we catching hell, man. You know, as a nation as a whole, you know, but we catching hell for righteousness' sake. For Yahweh Shemal Shot. What you got?
But
you
the
know,
election.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Romans 11 and 7. What then? Israel have not obtained that which he seeketh for.
So two-thirds have not obtained that which they seek for. What?
But the election have obtained it.
That's what this is all about, man. This is about the elect. This is about Yahweh Shemal Shah and his elect, man. This is why we out here. Through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shemal Shah. We out here for those that can understand the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, man. Right. Those that have been predestinated to understand what the mysteries of Yahweh Shah. Read that.
And the rest were blinded.
Hey, it said, but the rest were blinded. What, to the pure, all things are pure. Read that again.
And the rest were blinded. Romans 11 and 7. What then? Israel have not obtained that which he seeketh for, but the election have obtained it, and the rest were blind.
So only the elect are going to get it in these last days. But everybody else that are outside this council, you've been blinded. You know, you've been blinded from foreseeing the evil. That's why in your simplicity, you're going to be taken. You're going to be punished. You see? Give me what you had. What you had. Yeah. Okay.
So James 1 and 21. Wherefore lay apart all filthiness and superfluity of naughtiness, and receive with meekness the engrafted word, which is able to save your soul. What we're talking about is truth that's able to, it's for salvation purpose, right? You know, this is something that you learn in the truth. You don't learn it in the world. It's about salvation, about being saved from your enemy, saved from turmoil, saved from trouble, tribulation to come, saved from indignation, the wrath of the Heavenly Father. So we're looking for a salvation, you know? You know, so before we get the crown, there has to be a saving that goes on, right? That's what Yahweh Shah, his name is all about. What he's all about is salvation. Where it says, again, wherefore lay apart all filthiness and superfluity and naughtiness. So, you know, you separate yourself from the old behaviors that used to take over your world, take over your life, right? You know, your old behaviors, superfluity and filthiness, right? As a matter of fact, if I grab that in the NLT real quick, it say, get rid of all the filth and evil in your lives and humbly accept the word Yahweh has planted in your hearts. And the word they use in the KJV is engrafted. You go into that word engrafted, right? It means implanted by instruction. I'll read it again. It says implanted by nature or implanted by others' instruction. Going down, the doctrine implanted by your teachers. All right, so engrafted word is a doctrine, right? A doctrine is a body of laws and a body of principles, right? Which you have to constantly be reminded of, because we in this element where you forget. That's where Esau's world starts to influence you. Now the evil starts to come back. Now the naughtiness, what the scriptures call naughtiness and superfluity, starts to take over your world. But you got to be, once again, the Lord engrafted you, meaning he implanted an instruction in you by way of your teachers. Our instruction is to be the opposite of that, be the opposite of how the world takes, the world is acting and behaving, especially these people on the sign, so that we can receive salvation. You got it, bro.
It's the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, and verse 7. It says, by faith, Noah being warned of Yahweh of things not seen as yet.
Hey, and so like it said, by faith. What? It take faith to believe on this report, man. You're not just going to get it without faith, because without faith, it's impossible to please Yahweh.
Hebrews 11 and 6. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to Yahweh must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Hey, and we understand that reward. That reward on you, hey, believing on this doctrine is going to lead you to salvation, man. That's what we up here for. To obtain the favor and mercies of Yahweh Shemal Shah of being delivered from these said perils that we warn you of, man. You know? Because of course we understand a destruction come, but the main message is what? The salvation, man. You know? And we had a way to salvation.
I'm going to say, not only do we believe in the report, but we trust in Yahweh Shah, man. See? See? You got it. We're going to continue on that.
Yeah.
Hebrews 11 and 7. But by faith, yep. Noah being warned of Yahweh of things not seen.
Of things not seen. You people don't see the dollar crashing, man. Even though it's plain as hell to the holy, but it's became a stumbling block to you wicked ass niggas outside this council that you got.
As yet, moved with fear.
Moved with fear. You know, that's the same thing Habakkuk said, man. What, Lord, I've heard that speech and was afraid, man. We were afraid when we heard teeth of wild beasts is about to be sent on you people. You people are gonna sodden your children and you're gonna bore them. You women, you're gonna be ravished to death, man. Esau, Edom is gonna destroy your families, your household, man. That move with fear because we understand Yahweh Shemal Shah is behind all of that, man. All the things that take place upon the planet Earth, it's a higher power behind all this. And we understand and know our power, man. Read that.
It says, by faith, Noah being warned of Yahweh of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark.
Hey, prepared an ark. You see, that spiritual ark is being built, man.
Right.
And we inside of it. And we looking through that window, looking at all you dumb ass niggas like, man, you just don't know. Lord gonna fuck you up. Read that again.
It says, moved with fear.
Fear. Read it again. That's the beginning of wisdom, man. If you want to obtain this wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the scriptures, it starts with you fearing Yahweh Shemal Shah. You know? That's the only way you're going to be what? Accepted to him, man. He ain't going to accept nobody that don't fear him, man, because the Lord requires obedience.
It says, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house.
To the saving of his house. You see? Salvation. He heard the report that the Lord was going to flood the earth. He moved with fear and prepared the ark so he could ultimately be delivered, man. But all of that was done by him believing on a report that was being taught unto him, man. Come on.
It says, by the which he condemned the world.
And we condemning all you niggas outside this council, man. We could give a fuck about any one of you, man. Because we concerned about the elect. We ain't concerned about you people, man. Because we understand, hey, you rejecting Yahweh Shah. So, hey, you had no choice but to die, man. It's a must that you be put to death, man. Because here it is, we're in the spirit of hastening the kingdom, and we still got people that desire America to continue on, man. But that's not in the will of our power. What you got?
And became heir of the righteousness, which is by faith.
Which is by faith. Keep in mind, you keep on going back to faith, man. Come on.
It's Luke 10 and verse 16. Yeah. He that heareth you, hear of me. And he that despises of you, despises of me.
So, just because you slap away, you know what I'm saying, you don't want to hearken unto what we say unto you, when we warning you, we're really saving your life. Because rebuke is better than secret love. Read it again.
Luke 10 and 16.
Oh, Salaki, open rebuke is better than secret love. The why?
He that hear of you, hear of me.
And we openly rebuking you. Come on.
And he that despises of you, despise of me.
Hey, so you may think that you just despise a mortal man. Hey, the Spirit had me say, what a word of a king is, there's power. So by default, you're despising your Yahweh Shemal Shah. Come on, we got it.
Man, come on. This is the book of 1 Thessalonians. So like the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 4.
Yes, you are.
Yep. Oh, you already had that. Oh, Khan. Yeah, the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 8, and it reads, he therefore that despiseth not man, but the Most High, who hath also given unto us his Holy Spirit. So they show you who they despise him by the way of the information we bring out. That goes back to Yahweh Shemal Shah. So that's who they hate. They don't hate because man itself. They hate Yahweh Shemal Shah because he's speaking the words of Yahweh Shemal Shah.
They say if they hate you, just know that they hated me first. And the scriptures say he the author and the finisher of our faith. I say the author author goes into the word meaning chief. Right? So he beginning. Yeah, we are faithful. Yep. How we know how to have faith and how to walk in it, even unto blood. No, we have not yet resist unto blood. That's the spirit that's on, brothers. Look, we got to go the long haul. We got to go that fight, you know, strive for the truth and the death. You know, we taking into all the accounts of the perils of Paul and through the epistles that we read, the perils of Stephen and certain martyrs, and you know, this thing becomes realer and truer. And the more you walk it, you know, it's a fine line, but the more you walk it, it becomes, it takes over your life, it's, you know, it takes over more of your life, it requires more. The script said, present your bodies as a living sacrifice, so it's constantly, you know, really, it begins to mold you, you know, yeah, fashion you into a new creature, right, like we just read, put off, you know, the filthiness and superfluity, all the nature in which you used to be and used to broadcast, because you're kind of like a broadcast, you're your own personal broadcasting system. So the people watch you and watch your behavior and mannerisms and the way the human mind works, it adapts to what it sees, and you draw people in, and you got certain figures who are more, let's say, like, they're more, you know, you want to follow after them. They're more like showing leadership, and so Esau knows that. So he uses it against us, and we're like a sheep shepherd. You know, we're a sheep type of people, man. You know, in need of leadership. So here it is. The Lord set prophets up in this end time, not to be ignored. The word here, not to be ignored, but to hearken unto, to hear, and in hearing what you're hearing, it's things that's cautioning. It's a caution. It's a letter of caution. It's a letter of lamentations for those that don't listen.
Right. It goes back to the ministry of Noah. Directly linked right back to Yahweh Shai and his testimony. Saying that it promoted prophets and warning. Matter of fact, let's get that real quick. Jeremiah, the 6th chapter, the scriptures out. Really, this is the decree. Everything that we're saying is backed up by a certain order. You know, it's authorized by Yahweh Shai, the invincible God. You see? So this is really a testimony in the next chapter, because you have guys that become privy of the scriptures. Scriptures can be captivated. You know, if you're on a mission, you're trying to find yourself. You come across the scriptures. Right? Then you can somewhere get a feel for these levels. You have to be accompanied with the Holy Spirit, man, the comforter. Now, what's the comforter? It taps into the future. It taps into the deep future of America. And you have to believe that. You can have a Bible, but the warning is going to speak about that uncertain sound. And think not that we're looking to bring in people. We understand that it's waning, that this system is waning. We're about to transition into the kingdom of heaven, man. That's why we up here. Prophesied the downfall, collapse of America, overall destruction of it, and the second coming of Yahweh Shai. Right here. Come on, God.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 6, verse 10. To whom shall I speak and give warning?
Yep, read that again.
To whom shall I speak and give warning?
See, so the doctrine, you know, on this day, the overtone of it is a warning. Why do you think we keep bringing up the famine? The power outage. Oh, we were just speaking about that, about how the power outage, I was speaking to God about it. The naysayers, one of the subtle moves of the Lord is when the power go out, man. It's going to set a certain tone. It's going to change the dynamic of people. Operating without your phone, TV, or power itself, light. And that day, those who had a report, who truly believed on the testimony of the shot, it's going to be an overwhelming spirit. It's going to be a heavy balance, right? Because you're being in the flesh. But at the same time, you're going to be somewhat excited. Seeing that the testimony, the doctrine that you described to, testimony of Yahweh Shai checks out.
says, to whom shall I speak and give warning that they may hear? Behold, their ears are circumcised, and they cannot hearken. Behold.
Yeah, they can't comprehend, man. God's reminding.
Behold, the word of the Lord is unto them a reproach. They have no delight in it.
Yeah, because it's a sobering message. What you find out is we promote. Let's get that. Ezekiel, the second chapter. Can somebody give a... Yeah, Ezekiel 2 and 10.
It's the book of Ezekiel, chapter 2 and verse 10. And he spread it before me, and it was written within and without.
Right, that's talking about the Holy Scripture, man. Huh? This is what life is documented. The trauma is all documented in the Scripture. Slavery, that traumatizing moment for your people, that's documented in the Scripture. You don't see that, go ahead.
And there was written therein lamentations and mourning and woe.
Right, this is what the book entails. Lamentations, mourning, and woe. Hey, even in salvation, it's going to be woe and lamentation and mourning. See that? Yeah, come on.
The book of Habakkuk, chapter 3, and I start at verse 13. It says, thou wentest forth for the salvation of thy people, even for the salvation of thine with thine anointed. Thou woundest the head out of the house of the wicked by discovering the foundation of the neck, Salah.
Yep, and that's on display as we speak, man, the transition of power that's taking place. And the Lord has set his sights on Esau, man, set his face against Mount Seir. And in the process, exposing him for his wicked deeds, his crimes against the law and order, the ordinance of Yahweh by Shemal Shah. And that's heavy, the Lord got us, right? He visited us for going off, but he used Esau to carry it out, in which Esau did it within the confines of breaking the laws, man. You see? That's the snare that which is the Lord, man. So the Lord is justified in destroying Esau. Because when you think about it, matter of fact, let's prove that. Go to Psalm 83, start at the top. Spirit, we're going to get on the so-called white man. Why you think we out here? We ain't playing it off, man. Why would we be in America, Babylon the Great? And the scriptures promote the destruction. This is the climax of the drama. I'm down here, man. This is the climax of the drama. If you're in the spirit of prophecy, that's what you're going to, the spirit, the momentum going to shift into the so-called white man. Real talk, I'm telling you. If you're in the spirit of prophecy, if you're in the spirit of Ezekiel 30, yo, you be going into the stock market. It won't care what you going into.
No, I definitely say that you make a video about a garment.
Right, spirit on you gonna shift into get into Esau, man. Yeah, because why wouldn't you? When this is gonna be the climax, this is the Lord's beautiful piece of work. That's touching the kingdom's fall, the fall of the kingdoms. Ain't gonna be nothing like how the Lord visited America. That's in the book of Jeremiah. Right, 16, man. 14. All right, come on.
Time. The book of Psalm 83 and 1. Keep not thou silent, O Yahweh Shemal Shah. Hold not thy peace and be still and be not still.
Right, which in its perfection. What we reading right here is playing out real time. This is an example of the Lord not keeping silent, man. The Lord is beginning to,
make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lift up the head.
Like, yeah, that's an act of war, man. Like, they lift up their head. That's the time we're in. You see America being fenced in, the system, the mentality. Oh, I was speaking about that, right, in the spirit. We have been to dwell within the house of David really is in the spirit of your mind. We're going from room to room in these chambers, pretty much. Everything you do, I don't care what you might look at, IG, whatever you might be into. If you're in the spirit, you're going to go right back to the scriptures. That's going to be the stability of your time. Being able to really accept reality. When this system began to crumble, the walls start closing in on you Babylonians, this particular spirit, they're going to sing in that day. Why? Because that's going to be one step closer to the return of Yahweh Shai. Go ahead.
Okay. It reads, verse 3, they have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones.
Right, who are guilty of that offense, the so-called white man. Why is that important? Because he was said to be in power at the return of the Lord. 2 Ezra, the 6th chapter. What he saw is synonymous with the end. So we know that we're in the end by, if for nothing else, the so-called white man being in power. These strange laws, the perverse vibration out here in America. You should be vexed that time. If you just cool all the time, you ain't in the spirit. We're going to just simplify it for you, you know? You can throw around these mythical words, the spirit, but what does it mean to be in the spirit? It means to walk in the light, to be tapped, to be in harmony and sequence, has synergy with what the scripture said. In that event, you will know that one of the characters cast would be the elect. And they'll have a certain spirit on them. They'll really hate this world. Yeah, come on, Yeah, come on.
Kind of Psalms 10 and verse 5. His ways are always grievous. Thy judges are, Psalms 10 and 4. The wicked, through the pride of his countenance, will not seek after the Most High.
Right. What does scripture mean when it says through the pride of his countenance? That really goes into his laws and legislation. Not just him looking a certain way. Even though that's an aspect of it. Because wisdom is in all things. Wisdom is Solomon in the 12th chapter. But ultimately, that countenance, that's equivalent to the same image, the image. The face that represents the system. Right? All right? The pride of his countenance. He's got to set up here a devil about himself coming to the, you know, the ordinance. How about you now? So read that again.
Kind of Psalms 10 and 4, the wicked through the pride of his countenance will not seek after the Most High.
See, go ahead.
The Most High is not in all his thoughts.
Right, his secret beings. He can talk ways to move forward, to advance in his diabolical plans. You're dealing with the real devil. Right? The fool he gives you, you don't have to go into some dark web video. No. Go to Matty Dollars. You know, as the devil. Simplicity that which is in your house shot, man. If you know what season you're in, you know that this is the end, then you know that the devil is in power. Now you start to look for the rat droppers. Go ahead,
huh? He says.
Oh, that's spirit.
I've seen the traps out of his head like old, like rat
hole. Oh, man. That's good, man. Don't go on that street if the demons get on you. Go
back. Psalms 10 and 5, it says, his ways are always grievous. Thy judgments are far, far above, out of his sight. Mm-hmm. As for his enemies, he puffeth at them.
Right, that's Esau, the so-called white man. That's his approach, man. That's his very makeup. He's driven by what? Seeing that his blessing is the sword. Scripture refers to this man as the cunning hunter. You people being scared, you don't even know it. This is about to be a hard shift. It's about to be a more draconian feel. And guess what? We ain't gonna even look it up. You look it up. He's late in the game. He's about to the art. Get into the art. You won't really explain things to you. right now, everybody's probably pretty much settled into their lot. We just waiting out.
That's what I'm going to
say. Yeah, come on, Uncle.
Just going back to what you said, you know, about the, you're making a great point about the spirit, being in the spirit, throwing around some mystical word. You ain't vexed at some time of day. You ain't in the spirit. This is, the point is in 7 and 8. I'm going to start at verse 6. 2 Peter 2 and 6. Oh, you had that? Oh, real. Oh, you got it. Go ahead.
Second Peter 2 and 6. And turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemned them with an overthrow, making them an example unto those that after should live ungodly.
Right, that's well documented. Sodom and Gomorrah, the five neighboring cities. The Lord performed a great work, right? Overthrew them with strange calamity. It was set for an example. That's a strike fear in you, man. That's why you got no words. Intensity behind these words. Yep, read that again, huh?
God, it says, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemned them with an overthrow, making them an example.
Right, again, that word example pretty much translates to a sample. Sample size, meaning that the main course is surely coming. And the main course is just that. It's going to far exceed the sample. Yeah, that's how the Lord going to visit you, man. In the form of strange works that's going to excel past, you know, the works of old. Egypt, Sodom and Gomorrah, where?
If I made you, I can show you that. Even though those events actually happened, they recorded, it had a prophetic overtime to it. And then Romans 15, Lord ran four times, ran five, right? So it showed that it was going to happen again. It's going back. It said that his sample showed that it was a main course coming after that.
Giving you a sample, right? A glimpse into the works of the Lord. And it's actually similarities with certain of those kingdoms and their fall. Ancient Egypt, rivers being turned to blood, that contributed to a famine, as well as the crops being eaten. That affected the economy of the Egyptians. Yeah. Go ahead.
Khan, it says, and delivered just like.
Oh, so like also one of the plagues, one of the more heavy, one of the heaviest plagues that the Lord visited the first war, man. Yeah. Right, of the Egyptians. That was a symbolic prophetic overtone to it. Because your son assured that your legacy would continue on the throne. So that was a symbolic overtone. The Lord took the firstborn. Now how is that relevant to now? Well, the Lord said he's going to destroy both son and nephew for you, son. So the nephew adds to the main course instead of the separate side, right?
It said, and delivered just like, vexed with the filthy conversation of the wicked, for that righteous man dwelling among them.
Right. Noah is going into the characteristics of Selachia. Lot. He was vexed in the spirit, and he was dwelling amongst the people. That's why the Lord thrust us right in the midst of Babylon the Great. We have a front row seat to the wickedness, the perverseness of Esau. And everything vexes you, man. Or like the brother sent a video earlier, like to get you fired up. 6'8" nigga. I mean, this is what you can see at any time. Like, just a big nigga with some biker shorts. On a bike. Oh, they say them niggas out of Atlanta, they say they just open with it. They just try to be real aggressive. That happened in the time of Lot. That was the same spirit, man. Remember the angels? See that? That was all the foreshadowing of this sick, twisted time we in. Yes, so you know discretion. Come on.
It says, for that righteous man dwelling among them, in seeing and hearing.
Right, you see and hearing. You hear reports, you see things, you see it on your feed, chat. You see it and you hear it. That's just the tip of the iceberg. You go into the plans of Esau, his desires, that perpetual hatred he has for you. You know, this man systematically laying out snares and traps for you to suffice that ancient hatred. See, that makes you vexed in the spirit as well. Well,
it says, for that righteous man dwelling among them, in seeing and hearing, vexed his righteous soul from day to day with the unlawful deeds.
Yeah, see that? add to the point. You can gauge whether you're in the spirit or not based upon how you mess with, right? There's only two forces, man, righteousness and wickedness. So either you mess with one and you pretty much shun the other, and vice versa. And again, we gotta throw this out there. It starts with the mind. That's why the scriptures say, vex his righteous soul. The soul really represents your reasoning, the inner you.
Ecclesiastes 7:7, it says, surely oppression maketh the wise man mad.
Yeah. Read that again.
So Ecclesiastes 7:7, surely oppression maketh the wise man mad.
Right, oppression. Yep, that's the word. That should be one of the words that jump out. Why? Because it ties us into this time, this reality. You take a nigga, he can have third grade education. I bet he knows that his legacy ties back to slavery. I bet he know that. So that word oppressor, it should ring a bell. Would I read it there?
Ecclesiastes 7:7. It says, surely oppression maketh the wise man mad, and a gift destroyeth the heart.
Yeah, so spirit, if the spirit is on you, you're gonna be mad, man. Right? That don't mean you're walking around puffing and puffing. That could be out of your circle. Right? But for the most part, just seeing and hearing things that take place in Babylon the Great, it's gonna vex your spirit, it's gonna rub you the wrong way. Why? Because it doesn't align with righteousness. What's that? 2 Peter 3rd chapter speaks about the contrast of these two worlds. The world of calm righteousness is going to be well. This current world, this is where wickedness lies. And we ain't saying nothing that should be, right, captivating. This should be second nature by now. You got access to the internet, right? Or not even that, just your day-to-day walk. You just seen the big transformer, man, and they were trying to provoke us. There's a guy in his late 40s, man, with a wig on, man. Come on, man, we can see through that. I thought we were gonna jump out there, like, get a piece of something. Alright.
Proverbs 29:27. An unjust man is an abomination to the just.
Mm-hmm.
And he that is upright in the way is an abomination to the wicked.
Right, yeah, it's either or, man. Those who are upright in heart, upright in the way, that means you reason in righteousness. That in itself is dangerous. Because to control the system, you have to control the mind. You know, prove that, and you go into that word government. You break it down. Govern means to control, and mint goes back to mental. Really, government translates the mind control. That's where it all starts. So now, you have been changed. You heard the report, and it changed your outlook on things, the way you think. These devils, they want to control all that. That's why they keep tabs, they monitor what you're searching, right? What?
The book of Psalm. Psalm 83:3. Psalm 83:3, it said they have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
Yeah, and they accomplished their feet. Prior to being exposed to the truth, our people, we didn't know who we were, man. And even to this very day, right, as a whole, the two-thirds of the nation of Israel, even those who might have came across these teachers, they don't really believe, right? And even if they do, the filthy lucre, they might just sell out and compromise the stent. Well, that proves that they accomplished that feat by cutting you off from being a nation. It started with you directly identifying yourself with these corporate names, Negroes and Puerto Ricans, Haitians, and Jamaicans, and whatnot, to just all together falling away from your custom, holding fast to the ways of the heathen, Christmas, Thanksgiving, these high holy days. See? So, starting with the so-called white man, the nations accomplished their feat. They cut us off from being a nation. And really, it was handed by Esau. And that's in the book of, matter of fact, let's continue right here. And then we are going to cover the sixth chapter. The 16th verse.
Yeah. It says, for they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee, the tabernacles of Edom, and the Israelites, and the Moab, and the Hagarenes, Gebal and Ammon, and Amalek, the Philistines, with the inhabitants of Tyre.
Right, so you see what Esau, the so-called white man, headed the list, the tabernacles of Edom, which, if you read with understanding, you feel the prophetic overtones of that. Because why is Edom at the hill? Their power here in this reality. The time when the supper is ready, all things are now ready, the books are ready, he will be in power. So he's going to be the manifestation, if you will, of the nation cutting us off. It's going to be through him.
Well, in the book of Proverbs chapter 6 and verse 16, these things who of the Lord hate, yeah, seven are an abomination unto them.
Right, and there's seven. Submits the complete hatred of the Lord as touching that particular thing. So what we're about to read is one who the Lord completely hates. You're going to see where it ties directly to Esau, right?
A proud look.
See, a proud look, right up the onset, man. That's dealing with the so-called white man. The word proud is synonymous with Esau. Well,
a lying tongue.
Right, a lying tongue. The reason why you had to research truth, because the so-called white man was in power. But think about that. You have to research who you are. That means the vibration in that particular place, wherever one might be there, is live. Well,
it says in hands that shed innocent blood.
Oh, we ain't even got to break that down. That's another characteristic of the so-called white man. Accurately. Read that again.
It says, in hands that shed innocent blood.
Yeah, the so-called white man was responsible for that offense. Shed innocent blood. The scriptures tell you in the book of Ezekiel, 35th chapter, how this man had not hated blood. So he pretty much desired the blood, and really the prize is the nation of Israel. You're going to see that. It's going to build up to this man coming after Israel. That's in the book of Revelation, the 12th chapter. And in particular, those of us who have a testimony of Yahweh Shah. Go ahead.
In heart, they're devising wicked imaginations.
Right, they're dealing with Esau. And what's that wicked imagination his heart is devising as it relates to now, reality? And seeing that this is the end, before it's not another kingdom on these, right? Besides, say, the kingdom of heaven that's coming. So as it pertains to now, that mischievous device we have imagined in his heart, we got the sun. It's the prerogative, man. So you see where it's even a prophetic overtone to, like the book of Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, you said that those are the teachers of the house shine infants.
It says, feet that be swift and running to mission.
Right, so-called white men. Feet be swift. And even physically manifested through his plane. He could descend upon your country within a matter of hours. What?
A false witness that speak of lies.
Right, a false witness that speak of lies. Esau scriptures tell you how he will be the accuser of his brother. That's all numbers this man has been a false accuser of Israel. He could go into individual examples. What's the guy, Carneal? Now he was wrongly accused, right? Was that the case? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wrongfully for rape.
Yeah, for rape.
Yeah.
That's a settled, that's the individual case. But then for an example, the crime, right? Who was the face of the crime? It was the so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American. By way of Esau, he was falsely accused and blamed. He do that with all of his interactions with the nation. He created a boogeyman, sent in a CIA op. And that's what I got. You get a mouthful of the thing. Yeah, the spirit don't have to get on Esau, man. What up?
It says, in him that soweth discord among brethren.
Right, him that soweth discord among brethren. Esau guilty for that. That's one of the famous crimes of the so-called white man. Going to the whole Willie Lynch letter. And not just that, that's just looking at it at face value. This causing you to discontinue, you know, from your heritage. He planted discord with your lineage. Which when you go into that word lineage, it goes back to a line. Let's say you got a, you know, a verification system, like an extension cord, as they call it, these cords. If you cut that line, that's discord. That's, that cord has been detached. So Esau, single, he was responsible, he contributed. The Lord used the so-called white man to facilitate us being discontinued, but you see now the Lord is justified because he used Esau to carry out the very thing that he hated. It's Esau sold the hate of the Lord was on display through Esau, his hate that was kindled towards Israel. So they handled us rough, and the Lord said, look, I hate that work. So now I'm going to kill you, man. They're going to contribute to your many offenses. Scriptures all come together. Go ahead,
Al. Habakkuk 2 and verse 5. Yeah, also because he transgresseth by wine, he is a proud man.
Right, this man, he have different doctrines which causes you to go up. Oh, let's get there. Proverbs 7 chapter. It all starts with your mind, man. Scriptures speak about keeping thy heart with all thy strength. I also believe in that. That second Peter, gird up the loins of your mind. Yep. Yeah, guard it from what? The advancement of this human system. That's what it boils down to. Not putting your stock into the dainties of the so-called white man.
Proverbs chapter 7, and I started at 24. It said, hearken unto me now therefore, O ye children, and attend to the words of my mouth. Let not thine heart decline to her ways.
Let not thine heart decline, man. Like in a way, which you all should know by now. That's what God said for the doctrine. Not just doctrine, man. Traditional sense, ideology, philosophy, your way of life, your salvation, what you conjured up, whether it's in the form of you want to be the next LeBron James, and you're so dedicated to it, if you're an Israelite, of course, you're not willing to yield to the testimony. That's because you followed one of her ways, one of the many perverse ways of the so-called white.
for she have cast down many wounded. Yeah, many strong men have been slain by her. Her house is the way to hell, going down to the chambers of death.
Right, and that's where these different ways of thinking to simplify it leads you to the chambers of death versus the words of eternal life. See, there's a reward laid up for whatever path you're taking. That's why we have this truth. All right? We are pretty much dwelling within the courts. We are housed. Again, knowledge and wisdom shall be the stability of that time.
It's 1 Peter 1 and verse 13. Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Yahweh Shah HaMashiach.
Yeah, that says a whole lot. Now we're going to examine. Read it again. Right?
Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind.
Right. See, that proves it's the ultimate mental game. You're going to see that as your system collapses. That's what it's going to boil down to. Whether you're physically facing things, you can. It's going to be the way you react. Your mindset. And mainly, for the most part, right, those of you outside this circle are going to be taken with the first advance of the city. First invade of the city. Invasion, you're going to succumb, man. The only thing that's going to guard you, your sanity in that day, is the truth. See, that's what it's saying. Read it again.
Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, and hope to the end for the...
What that sober means, meaning not regressing, digressing, and falling away for whatever reason in the form of entertaining other doctrines. That's being drunk. You're all over the place, right? If you're not consumed by the word, by the water, then you're going to be drinking of the cup. But instead, go back to the east side of the water. You're going to be drunken. Scriptures say those who are drunken in the night. Meaning here in America, Babylon the Great. These different ways of thinking and ideas is going to be accessible. Well,
and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Yahweh Shah HaMashiach.
Right, that's the peak of it. Climax. Hey, but another key word there is hope. So when you subscribe to this form of teaching, really you're reduced to hope. You are now introduced to this power that controls your coming and going. See that? Yeah, come on.
This is Romans chapter 8, verse 24. For we are saved by hope. Mm-hmm. But hope that is seen is not hope. For what a man seeth, why doth he yet hope for?
Right, rations. You just got a pantry full of, right? Niggas got noodles. Niggas and noodles. Nah, that's things that's seen. Now, that's not the same. If you don't, you know, if you have extra shekels and the resources to get extra things, by all means do so. Right? But doing it, understanding that there's a power that controls it all. It's not you per se saving up, right? It's not you that's going to dictate your outcome.
A lot of them guys, they're going to stumble upon their storehouses.
Yep.
A lot of them guys that stock up food, there's going to be brothers that inherit that in some way.
Yeah, wine cellars. Not us. Well, that's in the scripture. It's an account of that. Remember the four lepers? That's scary. Yeah, the four lepers, man. They were chased out. I think it was the Syrians. Chased them out, man. They sacked the city, and it was four lepers. And they came back into the city. They were He was stuck between a rock and a hard place pretty much. And they went back, they stayed outside the city, they were gonna die to famine. If they went into the city, they would be at the mercy of the Syrians. So they went back into the city on faith. And the Lord had all the Syrians that he drove out the city, man, and left all their gold, raiment, right? He left everything, so what you understand, that's actually documented. That's a part of our hope. Oh, let's get that. Romans the 15th chapter. We've been bringing it up. And it seems like basic scriptures, but these are cornerstone scriptures that's going to apply when all hell breaks. And again, you just told it, you rooted this channel, former teachers. All hell about to break loose in America. That's what we represent. All right, come on.
Hebrews 11 and verse 1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
That's in a nutshell the definition of faith, man.
Right.
To where
you believe so much, you know, you can bank on. Yeah. NLT, it's a foundation. You know? Like, that is our foundation. Because the Lord promised many things, especially for his elect. He promised, man. You know, the scriptures talk about he is faithful who promised. You know? So, hey, you can rest assured that the Lord, his word gonna stand. And everybody else, word can't stand, the Lord word won't stand.
And only one exit plan. Yahweh Shah. Yep, sir.
Romans chapter 15, verse 4. For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning.
Right, there's different accounts. He just mentioned one. They were written for our learning, what?
That we, through patience and comfort of the scriptures, might have hope.
So we read about their story and we see how the Lord stepped in on their behalf. Now we got something to hope in. You niggas got nothing to hope in. This carnal thing, what scripture speaks about the flesh, flesh armor, man.
Trusting
in man. It goes into the things pertaining to this realm. Trust in the director. Orchestrator, man. Of all things. Yep.
Real quick, he's asking Sirach, chapter 2. In verse 10. Look at the generations of old.
And that proves that these scriptures, I was touching on that earlier in the spirit. Ecclesiastes, this prophetic sayings, man. This poetry. That's why it says consider the things of old right from the unseen. Looking from the perspective of being in the head. It conjectured a right way to come. Beautiful. That's Wisdom of Solomon, the 8th chapter. And to conject something, to be a conjector, that's offending. That's, you'll get pissed at a conjector. Because he's conjecturing something that's really not on the radar. It's not, right. Yeah, something out there. But then, it's right. It show you that in like Matlock. Yeah. That's why really, I don't like Matlock. Like the guy, I'm gonna be honest with you. Like the character, I watched the hell out of Matlock. But I hate really the character, just in the spirit. Like, and I see why people hate us. Real talk, man. Because he would conject, he'd come and say, well, hold on. Maybe it was you who left the keys on the counter. Went in and murdered him. And you put the, he go there, he go, when it sound out there, but he called the shit word for word. But that's how he called him outlandish shit. Maybe you killed him. Maybe it was you who left the car running, went into the apartment, and you hit him with the and you made him into the house and down the truck. Yeah, oh yeah, I've been watching that shit. Sometimes you gotta get out of it, but I'll be watching it for a minute. Man. Going back to that. Yeah, man. That's what he's doing. The motherfucker be looking like this bitch called that shit out, man.
It says, Sirach 2 and 10. Please ask us chapter 2 and verse 10. look at the generations of old and see, did ever any trust in the Lord that was confounded?
Yeah, you go into all their accounts, man. Where the Lord stepped in and delivered the men. That power is alive and well. And the fool that that's prophetic, because you can't say, well, look, that don't apply to Peter, but did not the Lord unlock Peter out of the prison from the Quaternion, the stocks, right? Oh, now that was Paul that got the stocks, the size. Then you had Peter who was locked up around the Quaternion. So when the scriptures say, look at the generations of old, that we read it today, then we're looking at that, man.
He said, or did any abide in his fear and was forsaken?
Right. That fear is being exposed to the Lord. That's the beginning of knowledge. The Lord makes you friend, acquaintance. You abide in that, then now that's an alliance that's been created. See?
Well, whom did he ever despise that called upon him?
That called upon him. And that's the way you got to call on the Lord. What's that song? Can we get that real quick? Bump up the side. I want to say that song 145. Yeah, you got this up? Okay.
This song is 22 and verse 4. This song is 22 and verse 4. Our fathers trusted in thee. They trusted and thou didst deliver them.
Right, yeah, we go into this intense, this heavy story, man. The three holy children, they was cast into that fiery furnace. And they trusted in the Lord. And the element of that trust came in the form of them not conceding to the king's decree. See that? So again, everything revolves around wholeheartedly holding fast to the doctrine, which creates a certain stance. That's why the scriptures say these are those who stood so stiff. What happened with the three holy children? They stood stiff behind a certain ordinance. And see, our fidelity is going to be tried. They watching us. They know who you is. Motherfucker, how did you enjoy your trip to Whole Foods? Yeah, most of them watching, man. Yeah, and you got them hot channels. Don't think just because you ain't got views like that, that's not a hot channel. No, your activity, you watching, you researching.
Oh, man, I said something wrong.
Yeah.
You'll see. You'll sprinkle me that. You're going to give me the 5 views. Come around and say something wrong.
They trusted in thee,
and were not confounded.
Right, they were not confounded, man. They go to that stabilized, active, and preserved. And even if you died, see, that's where this doctrine, right? This is where it excels far beyond the reading of men. Because if you die in this state, and you don't rise in your crown, the pleasure is evermore is taken away, man. We'll have men that's coming back, you know, gonna be raised up pretty much in the chariot. Deal with them and hopefully it's brief, you know, get through it. But for the most part, I'm telling you, I've been really sending up heavy curses on you, man. Like that groaning on scripture, speaks about that groaning. You ain't got to be all organized, laying some down, and you go into the Hebrew, which we go into the Hebrew because of the period. But sometimes you can groan. It's like, man, go up to 7 and get that deal. I don't like it. Yeah, and you know what? That's in harmony with the will of the Lord at that point. Lord is sending the family, man. Yeah, that nigga, he was an example. He exemplified, but like the mind of a nigga, the world of a nigga. All right, come on.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, and verse 7. Blessed is the man that trusteth in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is.
Hope the Lord is, man. Yeah.
This is Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 5. Come. Thus says the Lord.
Hey, if I may, it's just, this the spirit, man. This the spirit. We're speaking about the drama, but you see what it balance, the duality of wisdom. On the flip side, it set up an effort to comfort the believers because you're gonna need trust. You got to go into that time. You gotta have something. You gotta have something to trust in. The way this thing been set up, you can't trust in digital. Like I don't care how many zeros I need to put up there. You know, that's not nothing that you can hold fast. Everything is dark, an enigma somewhere, a mist, a shadow. See, the truth is our anchor. Watch when everything starts breaking down. You're gonna see all that when the question's gonna get asked. The nigga ain't asking you about what you said. Oh, you remember when shit was getting crazy with the crown and lockdown? That's when you had people start. Maybe it was a coworker or somebody you might have spoke off the record with. But asking, hey, what you remember what you were saying about, yeah, you know, there's gonna be the vibration in the earth, man. Yep, come on.
Good. Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 5. Thus saith the Lord, cursed be the man that trusteth in man, and maketh flesh his own.
Yeah, we were just speaking about that, man. Trusting in the carnal thing. But, hey, what's the signs behind it? That's the only thing that you got at your disposal. The mysteries, right? The ways that lead to preservation was hidden from you. So now you only have an option, you can only take these different avenues. Passing by that one street, that narrow path, you can't detect it. But
it says, and whose heart departed from the Lord.
Right, so what's going to happen? You people are going to trust in flesh. You're going to trust in these outlets and endure, so they're going to perfect your heart departing from the Lord. Right? That's everything. You see that word heart, right? Yeah, that proves the point. Everything's gonna boil down to decision making and reason, abilities, it's touching. Having the grip on things. What?
For he shall be like the heat in the desert, and shall not see when good comes. Like you were talking about that narrow path. You keep passing by that same street, you don't see when good comes. You know, you could have made that right turn and you know, went into life. It says, but shall inhabit the parched places in the wilderness, means not sanctuary.
Right.
It says, it's
the lack of ounces that's going to come.
Yep, why? Because when you're looking for answers, you're thirsty.
It says, in a salt land and not inhabited. Blessed is the man that trusteth in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is.
Right, yeah. Blessed is the man that trusts in the report, man. That's equivalent to being saturated, being confident.
To help me, I looked for the secure of men, but there was none.
Right, yeah, men. Men and anything that's considered carnal, that's not going to save you in that day. Yeah? That's not going to help you. Why? Because really, it's going to be an attempt to withstand the judgments of Yahweh Basim outside. You really get technical about it. You're going to find yourself actually coming up against the Lord. Trying to fight off famine.
It says, then thought I upon thy mercy.
Yeah, you had a right, you had six stored up. And certain guys, they even, you know, the more country guys, they got a garden somewhere maybe. And it's all worked out. Like, yeah, when you come back in that moment, everything's rotten. Yep, what?
It says, then thought I upon thy mercy, O Lord.
Mm.
And upon
all things of all. Romans 15 and 4. Things written before. Yeah, read that again.
It said, then thought I upon thy mercy, O Lord,
mm-hmm.
and upon thy ass of old, how thou deliverest such as wait for thee, and savest them out of the hands of the enemy.
That's it. He mentioned an account of the three holy children, Daniel, as well. We occupy that same lot. That's what you signed up for, man. Those who wait on the Lord. And that's going to play out in the form of standing stiffly. And that is concerning, you know, your stance. And you not yielding or conceding to this devil, man. Scripture said all that consent, right? What?
This is Psalms chapter 33, verse 16. There is no king saved by the multitude of an host. A mighty man is not delivered by much strength. A horse is a vain thing.
Oh, he said that's not. Oh, yeah. He said that king saved by a multitude of an host. He tells about how the Lord is the Lord's battle. He won the history. It goes to the Persian Empire, the immortals. They even though how the military was last, they were still taken down by the Greeks.
The plans of Yahweh Shemal Shah, no matter how big the army was. You know,
they even say what Alexander was praising
the Lord
against
it,
but
it's
the Lord's battle.
You know. It says, a horse is a vain thing for safety, neither shall he deliver any by his great strength.
Yeah, so it's nothing in this earthly round that's going to actually have you prosper, man. It's all up to Yahweh Shemal Shah. You know, it's the horse, because anything, power from your gun to a bumper, your money, is going to be vain to come against the wrath of your house by Shemashah.
If I may, that's that carnal mindset. You know, everything is subject to this word. If you're not thinking spiritually in your house by Shemashah, you're just going to be caught up in it. You know, like you had called for it in Psalms 145.
Oh, yeah.
Called for it in the spirit and in the truth.
fast somebody get there. You got something still got to go ahead.
It says, behold, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy. The Lord, like we brought out earlier, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And you possess wisdom, the Lord loves you. As the elder was saying earlier, you know, there's no gray area. It's cut and dry with the Lord.
So now you're hoping that you're preserved. You're hoping that you're saved. Hey, how can you hope in something you know nothing about? You didn't enter into the pool. How you can hope to win the pot? You know they have the little pools or the tournament. If you don't enter into the tournament, you can't hope for the championship.
See, Romans 10:17. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of Yahweh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that's playing into the point, man. Faith coming by hearing. You hear the word, you believe on the report. But it's all orchestrated by Yahweh by Shemashah. But not many have been exposed to these things. Matter of fact, let's begin. Yeah, that's the, hey, to give you a vivid illustration, right? Just an illustration to ponder. You're in a city. You go to, you can see how the city is set up. Got all these different streets, passed by these streets, avenues. But then you have these little alleys, man. Like there's only enough for one car to get to. And really, if you don't know where you're at, you're going to just pass by. You ain't even consider it. That's how the truth of scripture speaks about that. And this thing's in the 7th chapter. It goes into, straight and narrow. Yeah. So that's the scripture giving you a tangible thing for you to consider. To see how elusive really the truth is, man. People don't succumb because they don't know about the fence. First of all, they don't know about the great powers, Yahweh, why Yahweh Shah. They don't know about them powers being the same powers that orchestrated the transatlantic slave trade in a micro sense. That's low, you know, but in a broader sense, the flood. So the Lord kept them from there. Now, they can't hope again. It's equivalent to you not being in the pool. You can't hope for the pot.
Apostle Paul said, the crown is laid up for me, but not to be honest with those love is revealed. So they in the know.
They in that race.
Yeah.
And the scripture says, the fear of the Lord is his treasure. Alright? So, what you do with treasure, man? It's like it's a value, make purchases. You're rich. Mm-hmm. Right, so those that fear the Lord, like Brother Red, the ones that desire to be delivered by them, by the Most High, those are the ones that already was given unto Yahweh Shah, man. They came back with that grind, you know, that fear, what is that, move with fear? So it's like a token. When I say token, like not meaning a sign, but that's like something of value. You know, it was an incentive given unto you, fear, and faith, you know? You could be a part of those that didn't do that. Hear the trumpet blowing, like you said, and just start doing jumping jacks. You know what's gonna happen to them. They're gonna die.
Back to Psalm 145, you got that? Or what was you reading? Oh no, let's get that first.
Yeah. The book of 2nd Esdras, chapter 8 and verse 61. And therefore is my judgment now at hand.
Right, that's talking about this time, man. Everything is a build up to now. What?
These things have I not showed unto all men, but unto thee and a few like thee.
Right, so these things, what things? The prophecy, they haven't been shown to all men. Now, does this mean we're not going to be physically out of place? You're not going to physically see us? No, you're going to actually see us. You're going to hear us in a lot of cases. You're not going to be able to grasp it or what they comprehend to they hold the mind. So that's an example of the Lord not showing you all things. You can see the scriptures a certain way too. The Lord can put the spirit on you, and you can start saying things differently. Because you're not being kept with that water. Now you're in the desert, your water ran out. The little water that you might have had. You know, the guy's going to leave it. The water ran out. The well ran dry. Yeah, and you start seeing mirages out there in the desert. And it looked it real, man. And you with somebody, they tell you, no, man, we're going this way. You see the city? It's right there. It's right here. It's already here. The city is already here. We already here. You're like, no, man, we got more to go, man.
God, the book of Psalm 145 and 18. The Lord, Yahweh Shemal Shah, is not unto all them that call upon him.
Right. Meaning being in the presence of Yahweh Shah. And that order starts with you believing on the report. Put it like this. If you entertain the spirit of prophecy, right? If you entertain the charisma, then what we say it is, you anticipate World War III, amongst other things, the famine, right? Then that directly puts you in the presence of Yahweh Shah. That's his testimony. That's the spirit of prophecy. See? Read that again.
The Lord, Yahweh Shah, is nigh unto all them that call upon him. Mm-hmm. To all that call upon him in truth.
In truth. See? That path you gotta walk. Again, that's a certain doctrine that's hidden from you. Yeah, come on.
This is 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 16. It says, take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine, continue in them, so you won't take heed. You see a mirage, you see something that ain't different, right? It says,
what? Take heed to thyself first, right? That's what we read. Be careful how it goes with the paraphrase, how thou hear.
Take heed, how you
hear. Right, take heed, how thou hear. Like you say, a spirit can be put on you.
Right.
When, you know, when you can see it either the right way or the wrong way.
Yeah, that's it. You don't control what you see. You don't control what you see. There's cases of that. Car come out. Yeah.
Dive into the pool. Right.
The Lord can alter the Lord, put the spirit on you. That's why the scripture speaks about standing stiff. It don't really speak about nobody coming afterwards and doing something different than the foundation. That's how you gotta view things. If you find yourself in a position where you're going up against the very order that you learned from, then now you gotta say, well, hold up, that really don't line up with the scripture. When did that ever happen? You might have one to say, well, the Pharisees were there first. Well, hold up, we ain't talking about the Pharisees. See, that way they'd be missing certain links. No, we're talking about which all Pharisees, whether, you know, witches or Sadducees, lawyers and scribes, doctors of the law. But we're speaking about Yahweh Shah coming down to the 12. Because, yeah, Yahweh Shah's whole life was met with resistance. Like, Yahweh Shah only started beefing when he got around the Pharisees. No, when Yahweh Shah was born, they were trying to kill him, man. And he encountered different men. Oh, like the scripture, the young guy who he encountered, he asked, and he was, do you know, if I'm not mistaken, I believe he was referred to as one of a ruler. Matter of fact, let's see if you can get that. If I'm not mistaken, I know Excuse me, Nicodemus or one too, I think the Lord called. Oh no, he called him a master. Are you not a master? He's one of the 75 men of the world. That's it, yeah. Man, it's like you go to it, you try to see what gets lit in their account. You probably go to the new level and see what they say. You gotta act like the owner somewhere in the house, South Carolina, but you can walk the scripture down with or anything just with the Pharisees. And right there, that chronologically puts the order that justifies you saying, nope, I can come up against what was laid out before me. You in the box, because Yahweh transcends time itself, man. Scriptures tell you that the prophets was even before the world began. So it's going to be a foundation first, right? If the McDonald's was there first, you got to go to them to get the burgers. They don't go to you. Man.
St. Luke 10 and 18.
You're going to get the burgers now. It's a problem, you know what I mean? Nigga, well, I don't know y'all saw the clip I sent, but the niggas got to fight in the McDonald's. They raided and invaded. Go ahead.
The book of St. Luke 18 and 18. And a certain ruler asked him, saying, good master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? And Yahushua said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good save one that is the Most High.
Right. So when you read this story, it goes on to tell you how Yahweh loved him. Right? Does that mean Yahweh got emotional with him? No, man. He was teaching, he was breaking it down to him. That was like a back and forth, man. In the account of Nicodemus, I want to say, is in the, we can go back there right here.
St. Luke chapter 18 and verse 18, it reads, and a certain ruler asked him, saying, good master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life?
Oh, yeah, that's the ruler.
And Yahushua said unto him, why callest thou me good? He said, there is none good save one that is the Most High.
So yeah, he came to him, there was pretty much dialogue, they were going back. They were going back and forth. Go ahead. Let's read a little more.
It says, and Yahushua said unto him, why, it's like verse 20. Thou knowest the commandments. Do not commit adultery. Do not kill. Do not steal. Do not bear false witness. Honor thy father and thy mother. And he said, all these have I kept from my youth up. Now, when Yahushua heard these things, he said unto him, yet lackest thou one thing. Sell all that thou hast and distribute unto the poor, and thou shalt have treasure in heaven, and come and follow me. And when he heard this, he was very sorrowful, for he was very rich. And when Yahushua saw that he was very sorrowful, he said, how hardly shall they that have riches enter into the kingdom of the Most High?
Right, now we know that in this lifetime, we pretty much given to the poor. The Lord is not asking us to just go and everything that we physically own, sell it, and go out and give it to the poor. Right? No, that's not what the Lord is telling us to do. When you read this account, you know this is a dark sand for teaching his word, man. Unload everything else. And because even when you consider a camel going into the city, he had to humble himself, he had to crouch down, and the baggage had to be unloaded off. So pretty much, there's certain conditions, if you will, terms and conditions that come with following after the Yahweh Shah. You have to sell everything you have. It tells you that also in another parable, Matthew the 13th chapter. Certain merchants, you have to sell everything you have, and you have to put your stock into what's being taught, man. And if you're on a certain level, then you're going to go out and distribute it to the poor. You're going to tell the nation of Israel these things. The elect is going to lay hold of them, thus, you know, submitting them in the story. Alright, come on. Yes, sir, we gotta worry about this. Let's go back to that Habakkuk 3rd chapter. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, put out the old man. They say the inner man being renewed day by day. Renewing their clean heart.
Con, the book of Habakkuk 3 in verse 16. When I heard, my belly trembled, my lips quivered at the voice.
Wait, you heard what? The report, man. Now this is concerning Habakkuk, but now it applies to those of us who have been brought into the hearing. Those of us who, you know, we heard the report, the trumpet, we believe, now our walk has been altered. Hey, that's brought by way of fear. You're like, man, the hell with fucking Thanksgiving to the point where you don't care if your feelings getting hurt. Right? But man, I'm not dealing with Christmas, you know what I'm saying? Or... Go ahead.
God, it says, when I heard my belly trembled, my lips quivered at the voice.
Right. Yep, voice. You look that up, you know, voice. Yeah, it happened in the third chapter. Yeah, look at them signs, man. You should tremble when you hear that. That intense heat. That's another reason why the scripture refers to it as that lake of fire. Because when a fire, right, you see that fire kindling, you see a wave. You ever saw that intense heat? Whether it's on the stove or whatnot, that flame kindling. It's hot enough that you can see that wave. Well, imagine that time a million, 2 million, 200 million to the highest degree. Everything gonna be waving. It's gonna look like you're in water. It's gonna be that hot. It's gonna look like you're in water. Everything gonna be. Come on. Yeah, you should tremble at that report. You got it.
Strong's 8:69-63, it says, voice, sound, noise,
yep.
Sound of instrument.
Right, blow ye the trumpet, desire. Those are the only spirits that's going to heed to it. What? Yeah. That was it?
That's it, the thunder.
Oh, the thunder, oh,
voice. Voice, I'm going to, yep.
We're doing the strong.
Yeah.
Okay, come. Yeah,
go to at the bottom. It said genius Hebrew Chaldee lexicon. It say or thundering, often used with thunder with a loud voice.
Mm. Power. with that word, you know? Okay, that was it on there?
God, this Habakkuk 3:16, when I heard, my belly trembled, my lips quivered at the voice. Righteousness entered into my bones, and I trembled in myself, that I might rest in the day of trouble.
Right, see, that's concerning now, man. And that is our hope, that we might rest in the day of trouble, which that trouble is going to be perfected in the day of World War III, man. It's going to be a heavy day in itself. The Lord sanctioned for those missiles to destroy America, Babylon the Great. It's going to be a very heavy day, man. The time, you know, whether it be at a certain time, you know, time of day, everybody going to be strategically in the position they need to be. You know, missiles going. All right, come on.
When he cometh up unto the people, he will invade them with his troops.
Right, the Lord is going to invade them with his troops, man. Go ahead.
Although the fig tree shall not blossom, neither shall fruit be in the vines, the labor of the olive shall fail, and the fields.
Yeah, they're going into McDonald's and all these closing. The laborers, your 10-year plan is going to fail, because now, prophecy is beginning to settle in. There's no entity out here, no form of jurisdiction that can offset that momentum. Like life springing forth, going forward, you can't stop that. You know what I mean? We're getting a little older, that's what it is. You can't reverse it. You notice Esau want to go backwards, but that's not how life works. You see the seed, then everything blossoms forward. That's life. Can't stop this train. America is set to be destroyed. But
it says, in the fields shall yield no meat.
Yeah, in the fields shall yield no meat, man. That coincides with the song that we sing. There's going to be a famine out here, which is already happening. That's why you got McDonald's just go ahead and close it up. Everything 50% off. Why? Because the foretold famine is closing in on America. As projected, you believe in the Bible?
Yeah.
All the way through?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, cool. So what we promoting up here is the Bible and its veracity and its proof. Because I'm pretty sure you can agree with the fact that there's a lot of different perspectives concerning the Bible.
Oh, true. Absolutely.
And I'm pretty sure you disagree with us. Yeah, see that? So that proves that it has to be taught correctly. It has to be a form of the Bible being presented in its veracity. We claim, we make that claim of it. So now, let me ask you a question. You believe America's in the Bible?
I believe in the Bible, everybody's in the Bible.
Well, that's what we're pushing, man. America's in the Bible, and it's going to fall under the category of one of the many great works of the Lord that he destroyed.
Good, this is the book of Isaiah, chapter 34, verse 1. Come near, ye nations, to hear, and hearken, ye people. Let the earth hear, and all that is therein.
Right, yeah, there's a report that's going out in the planet Earth, man. And all the nations are being drawn to it. Well,
the world and all things that come forth of it. For the indignation of the Lord is upon all nations.
Right, yeah, this is the time of the Lord's wrath and his perfection, which will be manifest in the form of World War III. Did you know World War III was in the Bible?
It is, really.
Yeah, see that? Are you saying you do? Are you?
I've
heard. The first time you heard it.
But, you know, that's not something they always preach on sometimes. They don't figure it out.
Right, right, that's right. I mean, they don't know. That's why.
I love what y'all doing. I really do.
All right, bro.
Praise God. I'll see y'all later.
All right, bro. Yeah, so this is the Bible taught in a certain... Right, it's foreign to the people. Yeah, because usually the Bible was set up as a means to bring everybody together. You know, to cast off these false intentions. Love. Love you, baby. Christian sitting there. As you should get pissed. Right, yeah, because when you find out the plans of Yahweh Shammah Al-Shammah, motherfuckers' ribs gonna be touching.
God, it says, and his fury upon all their armies, he have utterly destroyed them, he have delivered them to the slaughter.
Right, that's gonna be perfected in World War III, man. Well,
the slain also shall be cast out, and the stink shall come up out of their carcasses, and the mountains shall be melted with their blood.
Right. Mountains gonna be melted, man. That goes into that lake too. Could we get that? That'd be that Psalms, yeah, Psalm 50, that'd be nice. And give me real quick, put this on this.
God, this is the book of Psalms, chapter 58, and verse 7. It reads, let them melt away as waters.
Right, let them melt away as waters.
Which run continually.
Those waters, that's that lake of fire, man. Well.
When he bendeth his bow to shoot his arrows, let them be as cut in pieces.
That's those arrows. That's the arrows right there. That's the Lord pretty much declaring the destruction of America through poetry, man. Only those who have the instinct is going to hear it. It's going to cause, it's going to provoke a certain reaction. You're going to run for cover in the spirit. You're going to cleave, you're going to put your hope into an entity. Hey, and that in itself is volatile. You have to tell someone, look, bro, it's not going to be you. It's, you got to put your hope and trust in the God of this book, you know? But what you find out, it really makes all the sense. You have no control over that. Goddamn water get clogged up. There it is. These niggas on Instagram like they got spiritual power. But then you gotta call the plumber in. Like, shit get bad. Like, I'm just saying though, like, you're right, the things around you prove that you're at the mercy of a higher power. So once the Lord stripped those things away, then that's when that process gonna really kick in. You're gonna see those who truly trust, they're gonna be kept.
God, this is 2 Ezra chapter 8 and verse 20. Oh Lord, this is 2 Ezra chapter 8 and verse.
So this is what prophecy points to, the destruction, man. That's what our sight is set on, the destruction of America. It's only what, that's what it's gonna lead to. You come up here and inquire long enough, and what's gonna happen is gonna shift to the perspective of yourself.
Okay. 2 Ezra chapter 8 and verse 19. Therefore hear my voice and understand my words, and I shall speak before thee. This is the beginning of the words of Ezra before he was taken up, and said, O Lord, thou that dwellest in everlastingness, which beholdest from above things in heaven and in earth, whose throne is inestimable, whose glory may not be comprehended.
Right, that's dealing with the Lord, man. And his jurisdiction, his throne being inestimable, meaning there's no limits to the jurisdiction of the Lord. Scriptures tell you that even if you fled into hell, dug into hell, or ascended, Salaki, into heaven, that spirit is still there. Meaning the Lord controls everything. Just figure out a way to get to Mars, to heaven, Mars, and the same power govern over that planet, over that realm. What?
It says, for whom the host of angels stand with trembling, whose service is conversate in wind and fire, whose word is true and says constant.
Right, yeah, the word is true and says constant. That proves that this is the
Cun, whose service is conversate in wind and fire,
right. Well,
whose word is true and sayings constant.
Right, word is true, man. And saying is constant. That goes back to consistent, constancy. Well,
whose commandment is strong and ordinance fearful.
Mm-hmm. Well,
who look drive up the depths.
Whose look drive up the depths. What's the depths? The depth ultimately is America, man, the grave. Read that again.
Whose look drive up the depths.
Right, whose look drive up the depths. And that translates to prophecy, man. When you look, you peer out into the future. Whose looks drive up the depth. Again, the depth being the pit. Well,
and indignation maketh mountains to melt away.
See, and indignation make mountains melt away, man. And those mountains are going to melt away that the government has designated for the Lord's destruction, beginning with America. The depth, the Lord is going to drive this place, that intense heat is going to turn into what? A desert. Desolation. As well as the other mountains that's going to melt at the visitation of the Lord in that third war. There's a build up to all that. Come on, that's it on me. You got something? I go to Luke 21.
Kind of book of St. Luke 21, verse 25. And there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon.
Right, this is our job to give you a glimpse into the future, man. In the present time, right, as it builds up to that moment.
It says there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars and upon the earth distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring.
Right, so you're going to have signs in the heavens, which right now is heavy constellation alignments, so-called UFO sightings, so-called sightings. But simultaneously, you have things stirred up in the earth. And the hell with you if you don't know that. You ain't researched. You ain't got an ear to the street, so to speak. The hell with you. Scripture speaks about those who will watch for the thief. Right?
It said, men's hearts failing them for fear and for looking after those things which are coming on the earth.
Mm-hmm.
For the powers of heaven shall be shaken. And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in the cloud with power and great glory.
Yeah, so you see, that's the build-up to Yahweh's Son, man. There's no way you can teach the coming of Yahweh's Son without serving the word forth as form of a prelude, so to speak, to that moment. There's a sequence of events that's said to unfold for Yahweh Shai give. And we're in the midst of it, man. We're in the midst of unfolding the prophecy. So we sang in the song, we narrate it as it happened. And if your eyes are open and wet, you're gonna subscribe to it, you're gonna believe in it, you're gonna cleave unto it, and hope to the end that you're counted worthy to be delivered. You come up against it, give a damn if you got a platform, you teach, you got a channel, come up against it, then you're going to be numbered to the swarm. Simple as that. And I'm going to throw this out there. This up here, man, great millstone, where we teach, and you're on the camera, and you're watching these other groups and over here, just go head on, man. It's not entertainment or, yeah, man, great millstone, they make a good point too, but they go off on this, but I like these guys. No, man, get the hell on, man. Teachings up here is the promoting of destruction. All hell breaking loose. And we all in one mind, in one spirit, and we pretty much sang the same song. And that song is destruction, all right? So, it's So with that, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory
to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushua, Ba'ashem, HaKadosh.
The learners to our teachers, the head of apostles, the elders, great millstone. Shalom to the fellow neighbors out there.
Shalom, DTA, Bible Ball, soon.
Never soon. DTA, EOL.